this tutorial we're looking at something called present perfect. So present perfect in Spanish is el pretérito perfecto. Now, to give you an idea of what this tense is, this is a past tense, but it's different from the past simple, the other pretérito. So if we compare the two, we'll look later on at uses of the present perfect. But to give you an idea, first of all, what we can do is, if we say something like something in the past, jugué al fútbol ayer, or ayer jugué al fútbol. So yesterday I played, so jugué, I played. But if you want to just say, I've played football, it would be he jugado al fútbol. Or hoy he jugado al fútbol. You could also say something like, comí sushi ayer. So you can say I played and I've played, I ate and I've eaten. So the present perfect in Spanish is very similar to the present perfect in English, not exactly, but more or less. And as you make the present perfect in English by verb have plus the past participle, so I have worked, I have talked, I have spoken, I have seen. In Spanish, it's formed from the auxiliary verb haber. So they don't use the verb for have, they use a special verb called haber. Now what we'll do is we'll look at the, so it's the, if you say something like jugar, to play, so it, to form the past participle, it becomes jugado. And then you just say, he jugado, I've played, has jugado, you've played, ha jugado, he or she or usted has played. So what we'll do is, first of all, look at the conjugation of the verb haber. Okay, so here we have the verb haber. Now, haber isn't present tense, but it's not used as a normal verb. You don't just say he or has or ha. On its own doesn't mean anything. You may have come across the verb haber, certain forms of it, in the impersonal I, there is or there are, or había, there was or there were. So you've also got there will be, habrá, there's going to be, va a haber. So, but it's used, we're going to look at how it's used to make, as an auxiliary, to make the present perfect. So if we just have a practice, he, has, ha, hemos, habéis, han. And then you combine that with the past participle of the verb. So now we're going to look at how to form the past participle of verbs. So for AR verbs, for regular AR verbs like hablar, okay, so we take off the AR from the stem and just replace it with HABO. So if you want to say I've spoken, he hablado. You've spoken, has, with the two form, has. He or she, el, ella, or, and the usted, ha hablado. So the only thing that changes is the version of haber, the past participle doesn't change. And then if we look at regular ER and IR verbs, then we've got, if we take an ER verb, comer, or an IR verb, vivir, then to make the past participle, you just replace the ending with ido, ido, comido, mi
be me though.
Okay, so it's very easy. If you've got AR verb, changes to AVO, and ER and IR change to either. So if we look at some examples of, more examples of AR verbs, we've got, what is in hablar, we can have trabajar becomes trabajado. We've got escuchar, to listen, so listened would be escuchado. We've already seen hablado, cerrar, to close, becomes cerrado. And ER and IR verbs, if we look at ER, we've already seen comer becomes comido. What else do we have? Beber, to drink. Drunk is bebido. And tener, to have, becomes tenido. IR verb, another IR verb, we've already seen vivir. So if we've got recibir, becomes recibido. Okay, so trabajado, escuchado, cerrado, comido, bebido, tenido, recibido. What we can do now is, so if we look at how the past participles combine with the verb haber. So if we just look at a verb like an AR verb. So hablar. So it's going to be I've spoken, he hablado. And then yo he hablado, although we don't really always need the yo. Tú has hablado, él, ella, and usted ha hablado. And then nosotros, o nosotras, hemos hablado, vosotros, o vosotras, habéis hablado, and ellos, ellas, and ustedes han hablado. So, he hablado, has hablado, ha hablado, hemos hablado, habéis hablado, han hablado. So, if we look at another verb, an ER verb, comer. So, the verb to eat, comer. So if we want to make the past participle, which corresponds to the word eaten, it's comer becomes past participle is comido. So he comido, has comido, ha comido, hemos comido, habéis comido, han comido. To receive an IR verb, recibir. Recibido, he recibido, has recibido, ha recibido, hemos recibido, habéis recibido, han recibido. So the uses of the present perfect. First is an action or event that began in the past which hasn't finished. So for example, I've lived in Nottingham for I've lived in Nottingham since 2001, or I've lived in Nottingham for 19 years. So that's something which began some time ago, but it hasn't finished yet. So if you compare that with I've lived in Nottingham for 19 years, but I lived in Barcelona for 6 years. So I lived is something that began in the past and was finished at a later time in the past. So in Spanish, we could do that by, you could say, hemos vivido, we have lived. Hemos vivido aquí, here, por más de 10 años. have aquí por más de 10 años. We have lived here for more than 10 years, which it shows that it hasn't finished the person. Okay. Now, the second use of the present perfect, when you talk about something but you don't say when it happened, so for example, he comido sushi. He comido sushi. So this could be, often it's used with things which are done in the recent past, but when it happened isn't mentioned, although this could really be any time in your life. Or you could say something like he comprado un nuevo coche. He comprado un nuevo coche, or Juan ha comprado. Juan has bought. Juan ha comprado un nuevo coche. So this is something that's done before now, but we're not saying exactly when it happened. You could ask somebody, ¿Dónde has estado? Where have you been? ¿Dónde has estado? Okay, so another reason for using present perfect, something that happened at a specific time in the recent past. So, he hablado con mi jefe hoy. So, he hablado con mi jefe hoy. So, hoy, today, is recent. And it's in the past, it's finished, but it's the recent past. It's not a long time ago. Este mes, he gastado mucho dinero. So this month I've spent a lot of money. Or we could even say esta semana, this week. Esta semana he gastado mucho dinero. So now finally we're going to look at time expressions which we often use with the present perfect. So we've got hace un rato, or hace un momento. So un rato would be a short time, so a short time ago, a little while ago, a moment ago. Esta semana, este mes, and este año, so this week, this month, this year. So we're talking about expressions which emphasize the kind of recent past, so it's not last. If it was last week, last month, last year, or 2 weeks ago, 3 weeks ago, if it's anything ago, it would tend to be the past simple, the preterite, pretérito. Ya todavía no, so ya he visto la película. Already I've seen the film, so I've already seen the film, or you could say I haven't seen the film yet, so no he visto la película todavía. No he visto la película o la peli. No he visto la peli todavía. Alguna vez means sometime. You could say something like has. It's sort of like saying ever. Have you ever done something? Or has comido sushi alguna vez? It's sort of like any time in your lifetime. Have you at least done it once? Rather than saying, did you eat, have you eaten sushi this month, or did you eat sushi last year, or when you lived in Japan, it's very open. It's not specified at any time in the past. Also, we can talk about how many times you've done something. He visitado Andreas. Dres. Dres. So I visited Madrid 3 times. Okay, so in another tutorial, we're going to look at the present perfect and the past simple, so the pretérito indefinido and the pretérito perfecto, and compare the two and see when you use one or the other. Okay, so hasta la próxima.